Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back. Once again, what is this? A brand new day, a brand new CPA strength video. And that is who I am. I am CPA strength. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. Licensed CPA, strongest one. That's who I am in the whole state. Yes, that's me. What are you gonna do? Well, today I'm gonna do something special with accounting. But what I usually do on a daily basis over here is I teach the world accounting through building blocks, the basics. Before we get into today's action, let me show you up over here. This is the best playlist in the world. This is my accounting playlist for beginners. This will make all your dreams come true. You'll be wealthy beyond your dreams. Today, we are gonna do Accounting for Beginners number 53. This is AFB 53. We're gonna roll on with the payroll, with the weekly paycheck. This is our third video of payroll. First one, we did the employee side. Second video, we did the employer side. Third video, we're just talking really about the employer side as well, but it's gonna be a journal entry. And, for you binge watchers out there that didn't really know what was amiss the past two videos, but now you figured it out because you see DC Adler. I know, it pained me. I just figured I didn't have room the last two videos for the DC Adler, or I wasn't using it at all. I still don't think this should go anywhere, but I don't know. But it's back, okay? I'm not planning on taking it anywhere anytime soon. This is what made a player. This is what made a player do his thing. Anyways, it's DC Adler, it's my mapping system. It's how to keep everything straight. Debits, credits, asset draw expense, liability, equity, revenue. And we're doing a journal entry with the payroll, a payroll journal entry. That's what we're doing. Any question, please? Anyways, we had dude or dudette work, anybody can work, dude or dudette, worked for $400 gross pay. And we figured out through the past two payroll videos, that's gonna break down, that $400 gross pay is gonna break down to a $325 paycheck to the employee, and then the employer has to pay $115 in payroll taxes to various agencies comprising of different things. $75, if you remember, was comprised of Social Security, Medicare, and federal withholdings. And the other 40 was comprised of matching the Social Security, matching the Medicare, and then about, $7 or $8 comprised of state unemployment and federal unemployment tax. But that's what, so out of this 115, that's the crux of the journal entry. You gotta figure out what it is comprised of. It's comprised of what? You know, $75 of taxes, because, and even if you didn't know, you know the gross was 400 and the net was 325. A net paycheck. So you know $75 came out of the wages expense. That'll come into play later when we're figuring out our second journal entry. But anyway, so there's these two transactions that are coming out of the bank account. Right? You had some dude work for $400, then you figured everything out, went to your bank account and said, hey, I need two checks. I need one check for $325, and then another a paycheck to my dude or dudette, and then I need another paycheck for $115, and that's in payroll taxes. And then the guy at the bank or whatever says, "Hey, that's $440. I thought you said you had a guy that working for $400." And you're like, "Yeah, welcome to being an employer." Huh. So we've got that established. So now here is good. I haven't gone too long, and we're gonna have two journal entries. So whether you care or not about payroll or whatever, and the journal entry for payroll, whether you care or not. This is interesting because we're going to do two journal entries, and they're both going to involve cash, so it's very normal. Now, I got a question the other day that said, now I get the asset. How is an asset being a credit? Because you always say asset is a debit. So how is an asset a credit? Because I always try to say this in the positive form. Sometimes I forget, but these are going up. Think about cash as the asset for how it could be a credit. Because it's a debit, you always say, but that's if it's going up. I mean, yes, cash is an asset, but in a business, you're gonna do transactions where you get cash, and you're gonna have transactions where you have cash leaving. Like when you buy something for the business, then you're gonna have money going, so you're gonna have cash going down, so that means you're gonna have an asset going down. And if a debit is where the asset goes up, so a credit is where the asset goes down. So that's how that goes. And also, we have $325 leaving our bank account. So let's do that journal entry first. This is gonna be the first journal entry over here, and this is the first journal entry. And then $115 is the second journal entry, and that's the answer for it over here on the right hand side. So let's do the first one. Now we've just talked about it. We have $325 leaving our bank account. We have $325 cash leaving. Where would that go? We just talked about that. Cash is an asset. It is leaving, it is dropping, it is in a lowering form, so that would be a credit. So $325 credit cash. Now what was it for? Now I will tell you, both the $325 and $115 are both expenses for our company. So they are both expenses. So this $325 would be, we already have our credit, right? So you know this has to equal. And so you have $300, and what in the chart of accounts would it be? You know, out of these six possible boxes, what would, I just told you they're expenses, but a payroll expense, it's an expense. It's something to keep the business going and stuff. So it would be an expense out of this box. So payroll, so wages expense. That's the debit, $325 wages expense, credit, $325 cash. Now let's go to our second journal entry, which is a little bit tougher. And that has the breakdown of what the things are. But let's go down to our second journal entry here for this transaction with $115 cash left the bank account or a check. Same thing. So that would be a credit, $115 cash credit. Now, why are there two things here? Why wouldn't the whole $115 be a wages expense? Well, because it's not, for a couple reasons. That you already have $325 of a wages expense over here, so you only need $75 of this is wages expense. If you took the whole $115 as a wages expense, you'd have $440 as a wages expense, but you only have $400, so there's something wrong because some of the money is in taxes. So here's how I would figure this out. This is how I figure out for clients when I do their payroll and then I have transactions come out of their bank account. So I do it through QuickBooks and I have rules, so it takes me a couple seconds, but this is what I do to figure out the first time. I would take $400 gross pay. That's what I want. We net pay the employee $325. That leaves $75. So there would be $75 in taxes to make them whole for the $400. So then you have this other transaction for $115. So some of it, $75 of it is wages expense, and then the rest of it is payroll taxes. So you do 115 minus the $75 in wages expense to get your payroll taxes. And that's the debit. The debits are $75 wage expense and $40 payroll taxes, and the credit is 115. Now you might be freaking out and saying, "Oh my God, you have two debits and one credit." Not chill, bro. That's cool. That's how things mostly roll. And now I always said it has to equal. It has to equal. Debits have to equal credit. There could be 200 debits and one cash. So, and that happens all the time. Think about, like, if you have a bank account that you have $20,000 taken out of for various expenses. You would just write, the journal entry would just be all the expenses and then one credit. So, but that's a different thing. So I thought this was a fun one since we're doing payroll. I felt like doing the payroll. I think I'm going to do like one or two more payrolls. Unless I have more questions or comments, then I'll do a lot more. Whatever you guys want to see, I'll make a video. I love making these videos. If you have a question about anything, you don't understand anything from any video, ask, because then, like, I see a bunch of questions on the same thing, and a bunch of, like, likes on any of the questions. So, anyways. Let's summarize this up. I thought this was fun, and the thing is one of the journal entries you have to split up, because it has, this 115 one has wages, expenses, and payroll taxes. Now, I have a couple more minutes. I was gonna try to make this fast, but you know your boy can talk! Anywho, so let's just look at what the three, let's look at the 440, right? 440 came out of the, let me get blue. Look, 440, 325, and $115 came out for cash for a $400 gross pay. Now, although you do have expenses of $325, then you have another expense over here, $75 wage expense to make them whole, $400. So you have a $400 wage expense, right? So you have $400 wages expense, and then $40 payroll expense, or payroll taxes. These are taxes. The payroll taxes. And this is the wages expense. Well, you know, and someone's like, "Oh, well, it's deductible. The $40 is deductible." So, like, "Oh, it's deductible. Okay." I mean, it is. But think about it. It just goes against. It's deductible, so it goes against the revenue you make. So it lowers your income by a little bit, so then it lowers the amount of taxes you pay by a little bit. I'd rather just have the freaking $400. So that's, you know, that's sometimes what you have to do when you're an employer. I want to go. I think that the next. I have an idea for the next video. I hope this was good. I'm about to run out of time. Let's see if I can get fat. Your boy's fat. I got my Frank Linny. Street gorilla. Repping my Linny boy, Frank Linny. Listen to a lot of Frank Linny for motivation. T. Rowe for motivation lately. Haystack for motivation. Jelly Roll for motivation. E40. Be Legit. I listen to a lot of music for motivation and think about all the haters and everything, all the people that hate on me my whole life, and then I just get so much love. I get so much love in this channel. It's like it's always February. Anyways, I hope everybody's enjoying these. If you did enjoy it, please leave a like. Please leave a comment saying what you did like or what you didn't like. And till next time, Have a great time. Try to keep things positive. Deuces.